Pixel device available in India right now is the Pixel 4a, and I've been using it for over a month now. So it's about time to give you guys my full review of the device. So if you're interested in this particular topic, then make sure to stick till the end. With that said, let's get started. I got the Pixel 4a way back in October, specifically October 27th, and I've been using it as my main daily driver device since then. I've also posted an unboxing and first impressions video. You can watch that on the link here or here. And I switched from the iPhone 10 to the Pixel 4a, and yeah, I'm really happy to be back on Android. So the first thing I did after setting up the Pixel was update it to Android 12. And yeah, the update was there. I did the update and I wanted to test out all the new features and the total design overall that Google has brought with Android 12, along with the material use theming. And damn, was I impressed. Software has always been the USP of Pixel devices, and that is also the case for this device. But first we're going to talk about everything else, and then I'm going to tell you my verdict about the Pixel 4a. On the outside, the Pixel 4a is a really basic device. It comes with a polycarbonate body and a soft touch finish, and it only comes in one color and one storage variant. So I have the black color variant with the 6GB and the 128GB RAM, and it is the only variant that is sold, and it is sold via Flipkart. But the good thing is that it does come with a mint accent colored power button, which is really nice. So the body overall is really nice. It's smooth to the touch, it's easy to hold, and it's very grippable because it is a compact device and it looks really nice in the hand. And yeah, it is super lightweight, so you're not gonna notice any kind of weight on your hands. So I've been using it with a tempered glass, and that does add to the weight a little bit, but even though, still it is a very light device. I would say the lightest device in the competition around this particular price range. And yes, it is a treat to use with one hand. So it is quite a sturdy device because I have had a few nicks here and there, but it still holds up. It doesn't have a single scratch on it. And yes, if you use it without a case, then it's gonna hold up really well. By the way, the power button, that is the accented power button, looks really nice. So both the power button and the volume rockers are very tactile and very clicky. They are very satisfying to click. But the only gripe that I have is that the power button is on the top and the volume rockers are at the bottom, which is not usually the case with other devices. So I get a little confused sometimes. But now after using it for over a month, I have gotten used to it. And I believe you will also too. And yeah, since it's a very light device, so using it with one hand is very easy and there's no fatigue on my wrist after using it for quite some time. So that is a really good thing that I would say is a plus point of the Pixel 4a, even though it comes with a plastic band. Now, in other things, the Pixel 4a comes with a USB Type-C port for charging and data transfer. And it also comes with a fingerprint sensor at the back, that is a physical one. And yeah, it is very fast and very reliable. And it opens up the phone really quickly. And yeah, since it is at the perfect position, like where your finger rests, your index finger, so it's really easy to unlock your device very quickly. And the Pixel 4a comes with a set of really good stereo speakers, which are really good to listen to, and you can play games, you can watch movies, you can listen to music on these speakers, and they're gonna be completely amazing. There's ample amount of bass output from them, and yeah, they are very loud. Listen to this sample. And last but not the least, we do have a headphone jack on here. That is a big thing for me, at least, because I love my wired headphones. And yes, the Pixel 4 does have a 3.5 millimeter headphone jack, and the output from which is really nice. And you can also use external mics on this, which is a really good thing. So overall, I would say on the hardware side of things, Pixel 4a has got you covered with everything. By the way, although technically the Pixel 4a is a dual SIM phone, but we only get one physical SIM, that is with the SIM slot, and the second one has to be an eSIM, which is a bummer in my case because I don't really use eSIMs. And yes, you have to get an eSIM if you want to use dual SIM with the Pixel 4a, otherwise you have to go with single SIM. Now on the front, we do have a 5.8 inch Full HD Plus OLED panel, which is really amazing, to be honest. It is a 60 Hz display, but that is not a deal breaker for me at all. I don't really care about the refresh rate, but yeah, I've toned down the animations to 0.5x from the developer options, and it feels decently smooth. And yeah, the screen itself is really nice. It produces really good colors. It is a bit saturated, but yeah, you do have the options to tone down the saturation and stuff in the settings, which is a nice thing. But yes, from out of the box, it is a good saturated screen. You have to tone it down if you don't like that saturated colors. But yes, it is a very good AMOLED display. It has like little to no black color issues, I would say, and there's no grain tint and all that issues. And yeah, overall, the display is really great. It also supports HDR 10 plus, which is a really nice thing. And it does come with all the certifications which you need to like run HDR and full HD content on Netflix, Prime Video and all that stuff. And yeah, it does support HDR on Netflix too, which is really nice. And yeah, it's really good display to watch movies or do anything like that. Because there is a punch hole camera at the front, which is on the top left, which doesn't intrude with anything at all, to be honest. And yeah, it is a really good experience watching content on this particular display, pairing with the stereo speakers or the headphone jack for that matter. So yeah, the display overall is really good. My only issue with the display of the Pixel 4a is that it's not very bright. It is plenty bright inside, but outside it's not very bright and it gets difficult to view stuff in direct sunlight. I would have loved a bit more brightness, but yes, it does support HDR, and yeah, when playing HDR content, the display gets plenty bright. There is also an always on display on this one, but yeah, I've turned it off because it drains the battery really quickly. Also, the haptic feedback on the Pixel 4a is really nice. And yeah, it enhances the overall experience of using this particular phone. So the Pixel 4a with the 5.8 inch display and the compact design is one of the most comfortable devices that I've used in recent times. And I absolutely love using it because one hand usage becomes really easy with this. And it doesn't give you fatigue on your wrist, which is a big plus point, I would say. Now, under the hood, the Pixel 4a comes with a Snapdragon 730G processor, which is almost 3 years old now. But honestly speaking, it works flawlessly on the Pixel 4a. I haven't seen like that many lags or jitters here and there. Overall, the UI is really smooth, courtesy Android 12 and like Pixel's direct updates on this one. So the UI overall is really smooth, even though it comes with a 730G processor. Everything opens up very quickly, and yeah, it is very nice to use and it is very snappy. It does come with 6GB RAM, which is LPDDR4, and you have 128GB of internal storage. And yeah, pairing all this, the overall experience is really snappy on the Pixel 4a. It is not built for gaming, so don't expect to game on it a lot. But yes, for day-to-day usage, the Pixel 4a is an amazing device. It is very snappy, everything works very smoothly, everything opens up and closes very quickly. And overall, the animations on Android 12 make it a lot better, and yeah, everything is fast, snappy, and I have no issues in day-to-day usage with the Pixel 4a. So if you're not a gamer, you don't game a lot on your phone, then the Pixel 4a is a great device for you for day-to-day and daily usage like social media, watching videos and all that stuff. So yeah, for that, the Pixel 4a is a great device. So basically, you have nothing to worry about on the performance side of things except for the gaming. Now, moving on, the call quality and the network reception on the Pixel 4a is really nice. The earpiece is plenty loud for taking calls, and you can also take like calls on the speakerphone, which is also a good thing. And Bluetooth connectivity is also pretty nice. It comes with Bluetooth 5.0. So yeah, that is really good. But yes, this is not a 5G phone. Keep that in mind. This is a 4G phone. And yeah, if you're planning to buy a 5G phone for future proofing it, then go with a 5G phone. The Pixel 4a is not for you. The Wi-Fi speeds are also really good, so you don't need to worry about all those things. The basics are covered. Now, the battery life on the Pixel 4a is just fine. It comes with a 3500 mAh battery, but pairing it with the 60Hz 5.8 inch OLED display, it almost lasts me the whole day of usage. But yeah, sometimes when I'm using it very heavily, I have to use the charger at around 6 to 7 p.m. But yes, from light to medium usage, it should last you an whole entire workday, with around, I believe, 4 to 5 hours or 6 hours of screen on time, which is decent, I would say, for this price range. And yes, do make sure to, like, if you turn on AOD, the always on display, then the battery is going to drain much faster. So I've kept it off and the battery lasts me the whole day now. So that is one thing to note. Now, for charging, it does come with an 18 watt PD charger bundle in the box, and it takes about 1.5 hours to completely charge the Pixel 4a from around 10% to 100%, which is quite fast, I would say. It's fine for a 3500 mAh cell, but yeah, it's not really up to the standards of today's like 65 watt 120 watt charging. And I mostly charge it at night with the optimized charging option turned on, and I have an alarm set in the morning, so it charges to 80%, and then just before ringing the alarm, it like completely charges it to 100%, and this helps in like saving the battery for longer usage, which is a good thing. But yes, I did see a weird thing that like if you don't have any alarm set for the next day, it's gonna charge at regular speeds even at night, which is kind of weird. So yeah, make sure to set an alarm if you like want to charge it at night so that it will use that optimized charging thing. Now, at first, like in the first 1 to 2 weeks, you won't see that good battery life. The Pixels generally take a lot of time to like get used to your usage and like read your usage pattern and prepare the battery for that. So it takes a little bit of time. It may take from like 3 weeks to 1 month. So yes, make sure to like use it and let the battery learn your usage so that it will give you better battery life. So now I'm getting like better battery life than I was getting within like 1 week of getting the phone, which is a very nice thing, but yeah, it is a little slow. Other manufacturers do it really quickly. So overall, I would say the battery life is just average. Now it's time to talk software. The reason why the Pixels are known throughout the world as the pioneer of Android. The newest dock, Pixel Experience UI based on Android 12, works very smoothly even with a 3-year-old chip, and the animations are super smooth. Everything looks great, and yeah, for day-to-day usage, it is nothing to worry about. The software works like a charm. There are a few bugs here and there, but yeah, those are not really big things. But yes, the overall performance of the software is really good. Everything is very smooth, and you do get a ton of features like exclusively for Pixels. So there are a few bugs here and there. Like for me, at like for the last few weeks, the YouTube Studio was crashing randomly here and there. Now it has been fixed somehow with updates, I guess. And there's also a new issue that I see with like pip sometimes. One issue with the notifications, like I don't know why. So yeah, these things keep happening somehow. I don't know, it happens one day, it doesn't happen another day. So yeah, there are a few bugs here and there in Android 12. But overall, it is a very good experience. And with the Pixels, you will get monthly security patches. I'm right now on the December security patch, which is a great thing. And yeah, you do get Pixel exclusive feature drops like every quarter, which is a great thing if you are a Pixel owner. And yeah, the Pixels are supported at least for the next 4 years. So yeah, you're covered. So yes, if you own a Pixel, you will get direct software updates straight from Google, and you'll be first in a line to receive new features for Android. Now, if we specifically talk about Android 12 on the Pixel 4a, you do have the material with theming, which is now slowly going across all of the like UI, all over the UI for every app. But yes, it is not the material. Icons are not really like available for third-party apps right now. It's only available for Google specific apps. So yes, the material U is pretty good. It just changes your whole vibe of the UI by just changing the wallpaper, and yeah, it is a really great thing, and I really love it because I love customizing my phone, and this kind of customization was not really available before. So yeah, now since material U is here, it's really easy to customize the devices. So if you want to know about Android 12 in detail, my friend Shares from the Tech Dad Out channel has made a few videos on Android 12, very detailed one. If you want to check them out, I'll leave the links down in the description. Go check it out, and it will also be there in the I button. So if you want to know about Android 12 in more detail, go visit Shares' channel and leave in the comments that you came from mine. Moving on, you do get like Pixel exclusive features. Okay, like the Google Assistant is full, the complete Google Assistant experience is there with AI transcript and call screening and all that stuff. You'll get everything. Okay, and you'll also get the recorder app with the live transcript and all that stuff. And yeah, you do get unlimited storage in Google Photos and many more things like this, which are Pixel exclusive. So yes, overall, I would say owning a Pixel is a great experience, and if you haven't tried it yet, you should definitely go with. The cheapest Pixel right now is the Pixel 4a, and the only Pixel that is available in India right now. So yeah, you can definitely go with the Pixel 4a if you want to experience Android 12 as a whole. And these are the small things which make owning a Pixel a really good thing. A few things which I don't like about the software is that, first of all, the at a glance thing, which is on the top left side, it covers the whole top, and yeah, the padding is there, and you can't even move it anywhere else and can't turn it off, which is really annoying. Because I like to customize my home screen, and because of this thing, I cannot really do that completely. It always stays there on the left side. And another thing is that the new internet toggles is like the Wi-Fi and mobile data toggles are sandwiched into one, which is like one extra click to get to the internet and like the mobile data and the Wi-Fi, which is not really convenient. You also don't have the call recording option in the Google Dialer on the Pixel 4a for some reason. I don't know why, which is a bummer, especially in India. But overall, I would say if you want to explore Android at its best and the finest, you try out a Pixel. Now, the final chapter, let's talk about cameras. We have a 12 megapixel sensor at the back. Yes, a single 12 megapixel sensor and an 8 megapixel selfie shooter on the front. So the back camera is simply amazing for photos. It clicks amazing photos. As you all know, we do have HDR plus and all that good stuff, which enhances your photos. But yeah, it does take a little bit of time to process these photos because of the like slower processor. And yes, the shutter speed and all are fine. Just the processing is a little slow, but the images that come out 9 out of 10 times from the Pixel 4a are just amazing. You give it any lighting condition, it will click a great picture. The pictures may not be the most detailed because it is a very old sensor, and yes, it is not very detailed. If you zoom in, you will see some like pixels, but yes, overall I would say this is a great camera for clicking pictures. But yeah, for videos it is not that great. You do have 4K video at 30 fps, but yeah, the videos are not that great. It is grainy and it doesn't look that good. Also, it sometimes misses focus for no reason, or maybe just the pictures are not that sharp. I'm not really sure, but yeah, it does happen. Also, if you're into portrait photography, the Pixel just nails the skin tones every time. I don't know how, but the portrait pictures come out really beautiful every time. Yeah, but it somehow misses the like bokeh sometimes, which is a bummer, I guess. In the camera app you also have the option to shoot raw, which is a really good thing because you can later on edit it to a greater extent. And after all this, you do have a built-in powerful photo editor right in the Photos app. With the Pixels, you get like exclusive features with that also, which is a really nice thing. So overall, I would say the Pixel 4a is a great camera for photos, not that great for videos, but yeah, for photos it is a great camera. And the selfie shooter is just fine. It's an 8 megapixel sensor. It's not that detailed. Sometimes the shot will come out really great and sometimes they won't. But yes, overall, I would say for photos, the Pixel 4a has a great set of cameras. So here are a few samples that you can check out. So there is almost nothing that I dislike about the Pixel 4a. It is a great overall device. It is lightweight. It is built well. It has great set of cameras. It has decent battery life. And overall, it's a complete package. And that's why the title of this video, that basic is the best. It covers the basics really well and it gives you everything that you need in a phone. And yeah, that's about it for my review. So if you like this video, then don't forget to hit that like button and definitely share this with everyone who is considering buying the Pixel 4a. And also hit that subscribe button to stay notified about my new uploads. Hit that notification bell to get the notifications, obviously. And yeah, with that said, I'm your friend Shinobi and I'm signing out. Peace.